यस अमृतपाल सिंह
सर, राइस का फेवरेट टेम्परेचर क्या है?
25 प्लस, पर वहां कंडीशंस कुछ लिखी हुई थी, वो आप देख लेते। राइस इज जनरली प्रोड्यूसिंग इन एरियाज ऑफ अ हॉट एंड ह्यूमिड वेदर कंडीशंस, वो आपको पता है, बताई गई हैं, ठीक है। वहां पर ऑप्शंस कुछ अजीब से दिए हुए थे, 20, 30, 20, 25, एक 40 वाला भी दिया हुआ था। हॉट एंड ह्यूमिड वेदर कंडीशंस आर अ फेवरेबल फॉर इट, ठीक है। तो लेट्स वी कंटिन्यू। Onshore mining when the mines are located on a coast of a country whereas a landmass has separated from the water body is known as a coast. For example, as Ankleshwar in Gujarat, it's a onshore mining. Offshore mining when the mines are located as a far away from the coastal regions. It may be in a water body or a landmasses. Bombay High, to which we extract as a crude oil. This is the example of a offshore mining. It's in Arabian Sea. Whereas a Guwahati Big boy in Assam are an examples of offshore mining. No, onshore on coast. When we move away from the coastal areas, it is known as the offshore mining. ठीक है ना? It may be in a water body, sea में हो सकता है, ocean में हो सकता है, land masses में हो सकता है. Korba in a Chhattisgarh is an example of a offshore mining. Clear? On the basis of the processes, there are four types of the mines are there. First, quarrying. Open pit mining, such kind of the minerals which are lies nearer the surface of the earth crust or above the surface of earth crust, we can extract the such kind of the minerals as easily known as open pit mining or quarrying. Q-U-A-R-R-Y-I-N-G, quarrying. Second is a rat hole mining, in which as we dug a hole on the surface of the earth crust by construction of a tunnels, we extract the minerals through which we can extract as a coal and iron ore. Rat hole mining. Third is a shaft mining. When we remove the topmost layer of the earth crust and extract the minerals is known as a shaft mining, through which we can extract as a bauxite, marble, granite. Clear? And fourth one is the drilling. Drilling is also a type of a mining, in which as we dug a hole on the surface of the earth crust with the help of a bore wells, we extract the liquid and a gaseous substances like crude oil and natural gas. Types of mines on the basis of a places are onshore and offshore mines. Onshore, O-N-S-H-O-R-E, onshore and offshore mines. Onshore and offshore mines. Whereas on the basis of a processes, on the basis of processes, there are four types of the mines are there. Quarrying or open pit mining. Shaft mining, rat hole mining. In rat hole mining, we construct tunnels on a surface. We are digging a hole on a surface of the earth crust by construction of a tunnels through which we can extract the minerals beneath the layers of earth crust. And fourth one is a drilling. By drilling and through the bore process, we extract the liquid and a gaseous substances beneath the layers of earth crust, crude oil, natural gas. Very good. Ankleshwar in Gujarat, Digboi in Assam, Guwahati in Assam, Krishna Godavari Basin in a southeastern parts of country, Bombay High in Arabian Sea are some of the examples of a drilling. Next, let's start the first metallic mineral. Mining is a killer industry. Keep this thing in your mind. Mining is a killer industry. It is known as a killer industry. You can note down this thing. Killer. K-I-L-L-E-R. Killer industry. Because in the mines, there is a threat to the life of a miners. Most of the times, the roofs of a mines, these are collapsed, which leads to the death of miners. Roof, jahan wo tunnels banayi jati, wo collapse kar jati hai, death ho jati hai. Sometimes as the water filled in a mines has led to the death of a miners. That's why it is considered as a killer industry. ठीक है? Till there any question? हाँ जी? Yes. Because development is not possible with this. Yeah. Today in our 10th day, there is a student asked that why not we have to reduce the mining processes? We can sustain without the mines, without the minerals. Raghav Sharma, we can sustain. For achieving our developmental goals, we need to mining processes. Mining has a threat to the nature, but still it is a desirable. At their place, we can as a substitute with the some of the other number of pollutants which can be as a reduced to other human efforts. For example, ozone has depleted due to the gas, Raghav Sharma, which gas, the emission of which gas leads to the depletion of ozone layer? Carbon dioxide? Ozone layer? No. These are responsible for a global warming. My question is, the ozone layer is depleted due to excessive emission of a dash gas. It has used in our refrigerators and air conditioners. Air conditioners, refrigerators. उन्होंने हिंट दे दिया है, पकड़ो इनको, आंसर क्या है? ऑनलाइन ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट्स, क्लोरीन इज अ स्पेसिफिकली यूज फॉर अ वॉटर, इन वॉटर. आप कहते हैं इट इज अ गैस, क्लोरीन इज अ गैस. ओके, यस, आंसर एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम, वेरी गुड, सो मेनी करेक्ट आंसर्स आर देयर. Nishtha, Shivansh, Harshit, all are given correct answer. Chlorofluorocarbons. Suna hai kahin? Yes, sir. Aap kehne nahin suna. Chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs. CFCs are responsible for the depletion of ozone layer. So let's start the first mineral, metallic mineral, iron ore. Chahat, what is an ore? Ore. Sorry? वो तो माइनिंग होती है. माइनिंग इज अ प्रोसेस टू विच वी एक्सट्रैक्ट द मिनरल्स. ओर, व्हाट इज एन ओर? रिमेनिंग उसको ओर कहते हैं. यस यू, वेरी गुड कार्तिक, निष्ठा, बोथ आर करेक्ट. सो इन प्योर फॉर्म ऑफ अ मिनरल्स द मेटल्स इज नोन एज अ ओर. Ore is generally as a mixture of a metals, non-metals and a rocks. So most number of minerals, these are extracted in a form of a ores, O-R-E-S, ores. Iron ore is a substance which has extracted to the rat hole mining. It, their impurities are separated in a blast furnaces. Blast furnaces. Blast furnaces to the process of a smelting of iron. Smelting of iron. Iron. Ore. It is a mixture of metals, non-metals, and rocks. Impurities of iron ore separated at a place named as a blast furnace. Blast furnace to the process of smelting. S-M-E-L-T-I-N-G. Smelting. Sorry? Furnace. The place where the smelting processes are generally practiced by the people, through which they separate the impurities of iron ore. In this process, as iron ore heated up at the temperature of 400 degrees Celsius. Under such circumstances, the iron content, it has separated from the rock particles in a liquid molten form. That molten form of iron is known as a pig iron. And that pig iron, it can be as modified in any of a sheet. That bench which has used by the Kartik, which iron rod, sheets, any of a sheets. Us pig iron ko use kiya jata. Theek hai na? During as a British age, when the first iron and steel industry, it was located by the Britishers at in India. Tesco, in which year, Chahat? In which year the Tesco located in India by the Britishers? Earlier 20th century. Exact pinpointed year. 19? You are reaching in the mid of the 20th century. Early 20th century. Very good. 1907 by the Jamshedji Nosavanji Tata. He observed the situations of India where as a possibilities of a location of a Tesco iron and steel industry, for which as he studied about the number of tribal communities which are living in India. So at that time, there was a one community was there, which was residing in a Chhattisgarh, parts of a present Chhattisgarh. Earlier, it was part of a Madhya Pradesh. In such areas, one of the tribal community was there, which was practicing the work of a smelting of iron. After the smelting of iron, it's easy for the industrialists to transform into as a steel. Steel is an example of chak. Steel is an example of, very good, alloy, mixture of two or more than two metals. After extracting the metal iron, they can use in a steel industry, for which as a Tesco located in a Jamshedpur, nearer in a Odisha, Jharkhand, Jharkhand, Odisha border. My question is, what we call to the that particular community in India, tribal community in India, which known, which familiar with the practice of smelting of iron? Something, something name pucha, something name pucha. What was the name of that community? Name of a community which familiar with the smelting processes in India. Smelting, because use of iron from a age old Indus Valley civilization, people, they were familiar with this smelting of iron. 4500 years ago. You are more concerned about it because you read all the three ages, ancient, medieval, and modern ages. Then answer. Answer. Which community known for the smelting of iron in India? Tribal community. Because of the possibilities of availability of iron, GN Tata, it located their industry in a Jamshedpur. Possibilities as a raw material easily available, availability of a water, power supply from the coal producing areas, easy access to the Kolkata port. That's why he located the industry in that such areas, not in a parts western or a southern India. Possible favorable conditions were present in a parts of Odisha, Jharkhand. What was the name of a community? Online and offline, yes. What was the name of a tribal community smelt with practicing the work of a iron smelting? Very good answer. Agarias. Agarias, A-G-A-R-I-A-S, Agarias. Mahars known for the sailing of ships, boats ke liye the. Mahar, boat chalate the. These were known in a Maharashtra. We are in Odisha, Jharkhand, wahan dham hai. Agarias, Agarias. So iron ore, generally it is a part of a metallurgical industry in India. Metallurgical industry. Mineral-based industries, those industries which are obtained their raw material from the mineral processes. Raghav Sharma, minerals, extraction of minerals, you will categorize under which sector of economy? Sure. Very good. Very good. Say you are. So generally, there are four types of iron ore has extracted. Types of iron ore. Magnetite, magnetite, hematite, magnetite, hematite, limonite, and siderite. Siderite. These differences in iron ore is generally due to as a iron content, presence of a iron content, ferrous content, presence of ferrous content. Magnetite is the finest form of a iron ore, which consisting the 70% and more than its iron. It is a rust free iron, purest form of iron. That iron has used in a Ashoka pillar of dash. Ashoka pillar. Particular place, Delhi ke paas jagah hai. Ashoka pillar, Noida, Mehrauli, Mehrauli, purest form of iron. Since last 2300 years ago, it was as a laid in a Mehrauli and still as a rust free iron. This is as a magnetite type of iron, which has consisting the 70 and more than 70% of iron content, rust free. Second is a hematite. Hematite. Maybe possible. But they were not familiar with the alloys at that time. Alloys, yes. They use as a minerals, metals in their, as usual, their original forms. In a railway tracks, as a hematite kind of a iron is used. This is also a rust-free iron, hematite, railway tracks. Hematite. In India, there are these two quantity, these two qualities, hematite and a magnetite. These two types of a iron ore is generally has extracted in a larger quantities. Larger quantities. Still there any questions? Hematite is generally consisting of 50% to 60% of iron content. 50% to 60% of iron content. Hematite. Hematite is generally consisting of 50% to 60% of iron content. Third, limonite, L-I-M-O-N-I-T-E, limonite. This is limonite. It has consisting the 40% to 50% of iron content. 40% to 50% of iron content. 40% to 50% of iron content. And last as a siderite, S-I-D-R-I-T-E, siderite, less than 40% of iron content. So these two are the least quality of iron ores, their reserves are limitedly found in India, present in India. Generally as an iron ore has extracted from the parts of Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Karnataka and Jharkhand. Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Karnataka and Jharkhand. Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Karnataka. The important areas which are known for the extraction of iron ore in India. Iron ore in India. First, Maharashtra Goa belt. Maharashtra Goa belt. Areas of iron ore extraction in India. Maharashtra Goa belt. Maharashtra Goa belt. In Maharashtra, Nagpur and Ratnagiri. Nagpur and Ratnagiri. Nagpur and Ratnagiri. Nagpur and Ratnagiri. Whereas in Goa, Marmagaon port, Marmagaon areas are used for extraction of used for extraction of iron ore. Extraction of iron ore. Shivansh, there are four types of the iron ore are there. Magnetite, 70 and more than 70% of iron content. Second is hematite, 50% to 60% of iron content. Third, limonite, which has consisting the 40% to 50% and last siderite is a less than 40% of iron content. Iron content. Next belt known for the extraction of iron ore in India is a Odisha Jharkhand belt. Odisha Jharkhand belt, which has consisting the hematite kind of iron ore. Hematite. Hematite kind of iron ore. Hematite category of iron ore. In Odisha, Jharkhand, the important mines are Badampahar, B-A-D-A-M-P-A-H-A-R. Badampahar, Mayurbhanj, Kendujhar, K-E-N-D-U-J-H-A-R. Kendujhar districts of Odisha, and in Jharkhand are Gua, G-U-A, G-U-A, Singhbhum district, नोआमुंडी, NOAMUNDI, NOAMUNDI. These are in Orissa. The important mines are Mayurbhanj, Badampahar, and Kendujhar. In Jharkhand, important mines are Singhbhum, Noamundi, NOAMUNDI, and Gua, GUA. GUA. Third is a Bellary, BELLARI. Third iron ore producing belt is a Bellary, Chitradurg, Chikmagalur, Chitradurg, Bellary, Chitradurg, Chikmagalur belt in Karnataka, Tumakur, okay. Belt in Karnataka. In Karnataka, Kudarmukh mines, Kudarmukh, KUDERMUKH. Kudar word is basically extracted from the Kannada language, which means as a horse. Kudar, KUDERE. Kudarmukh mines of Karnataka, known for the extraction of hematite iron. Clear? Kudar is a word extracted from the Kannada language, which means as horse. Fourth belt is a Durg Bastar Chandrapur, which has lies in Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh. In these states as Bastar and Bailadila, Bellardila, mines of Chhattisgarh. Bastar and Bellardila, mines of Chhattisgarh, known for the extraction of a hematite kind of iron. These are the important producing areas of iron ore in India. In India, iron ore, TISCO has exported there 47% of iron ore directly towards Japan because of FDI. FDI stands for FDI. Sorry? No, FDI. That was the FBI. It is a security agency of the US. My question is FDI. DI. Anybody? Online students, FDI stands for? It's a foreign direct investment. Japan has investing in a growth of TISCO. Their 49% of shares are managed by the Japan. So after the extraction of iron from iron ore, after the smelting processes, it has directly exporting towards Japan. 47% of iron ore. It has not used in India. If it will be used in India, then it will be provide as a job opportunities for the people. When we are exporting our finished goods to the foreign countries, it will be the more profitable comparatively to this. But due to the lack of funds, government has not investing their money in a growth of a TISCO, which has the first iron and steel industry of India. TISCO, Jamshedpur, Odisha. यस बट एफडीआई इट्स ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अर्लियर इन अ डेवलपमेंटल चैप्टर मे बी